Hallelujah. So we're back to that scripture. The scripture is, he that believeth in me, the works I do shall he do also.
Yes.
Do you believe in that, church?
Yes.
I only see one hand. Do you believe in that, church?
Yes.
Do you believe in that, church?
Yes.
Amen. The things that he do, he will do also. What did Jesus did when he was on earth?
Thank you, Jesus.
Teaching? Preaching?
Yes.
Healing?
Yes.
True ministry. Teaching, preaching, healing.
Yes.
You can do that also. Mm-hmm. Like I brought in here, I cried because Brother Brian, we went there and they said, I'm going to be operated. They didn't give him any kind of food, Brother Brian.
Yes.
I said, did you get the result already? Not yet. Okay, you have to claim right now
yes.
that everything is negative in the result yes. and that you're not going to have operation.
Yes. All right.
I was saying that to him, but without his faith, do you yes. think Jesus can do something? Yes. No. Hallelujah. It is his faith that made him whole.
Yes.
Right. Hallelujah. Thank you.
The woman who was issued of blood for a long time, it was her faith that made her whole.
Yes.
Yes.
Even if I pray for you 100 times, pray for you 100 times, yes. if you don't have a faith, and you have a type of blood pressure saying that, oh, I still feel the pain, I'm not sure I'm still healed. That's already that.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You can verify your trust in God by your words that you say.
Yes.
By the words that you say, you can verify your trust in God. If you're really trusting Him. The words that you say every day, what are you saying every day? I'm broke. It's going to happen.
Thank you, Lord.
I really have a pain. I don't think I'm going to get healed. What are you saying every day? Maybe while you say, yeah, I trust God.
Yeah.
It's contrast.
It's
contrast. When you say trust God, we trust God, you trust God 100%. Be careful what you say, because the devil will come into your thoughts. And then it goes to your heart. And then it takes the whole body.
Yeah.
And then it will become a stress. We call that a stress.
Yeah.
A stress is a curse.
Yeah.
When you feel stress, that is a curse.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
That is a curse. Do you know, like I said before, God shed his blood on the head.
Yeah.
Do you know what? So the head first, so that you will have peace. Rest.
Yeah.
When the doctor said to you that you have a cancer, thinking, no, by his stripes I am healed. Put on your pajamas, sister.
Yeah.
Put on your pajamas, brother, and take rest. I trust God. He told me I am healed. He told me by his stripes I am healed.
Yes.
So much problem. I had so much problem about money. You become your God.
Yes.
The love of money. Do you know the spirit of money is mammon? You can love two, you cannot serve two masters.
Amen.
Spirit of mammon and spirit of God. Mammon is when you love more your money than trusting God.
Thank you.
Let's just be realistic, sister. You may say that to me. I only have $50, and this $50 is for my whole week. I can't give God right now. You're trusting your money. You're trusting your money.
Hallelujah.
Because that's the least you can trust. That's the least you can trust to God.
Hallelujah.
You want God to make you to bless you mightily, but you cannot trust your money.
Hallelujah.
That's a contrast.
Thank
you. In everything, you trust Him. In everything that you do, whatever areas in your life, you trust Him,
yes.
and He will be there. Trust me,
yes.
people. Trust me, people.
Yes.
Trust me, saints. Trust me, church. When I say that, you have to trust Jesus.
Yes.
Trust Jesus 100% in everything that you do, in every area of your life.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
So it says here, verily, verily, I say to you, he that believeth in me, if you believe him, be careful what you say every day.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Believe in me, the works that I do shall he do also.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
He lay hands on the sick and they recovered.
Yes.
Jesus is whatever. You can do that too. But without the Holy Ghost, you cannot do nothing. You need the Holy Ghost, church. When you have the Holy Ghost, then you can do that. It will manifest. The gift of the Holy Spirit will not manifest without the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
All right. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. When you do have the Holy Ghost, sometimes you think this speaking in tongues is a crazy thing. Speaking in tongues is build up yourself. Before you do it, the answer to your problem is there. You don't know what you're uttering when I say, I didn't understand what I say. Somebody might have interpreted here. But then, the secret things that Jesus has in the kingdom of God can reveal it to me. Maybe it has something to do about my marriage. Maybe it has something to do about my mother-in-law. Maybe it has something to do about my father-in-law. As I speak in tongues every day, I shakarala, maybe it has something to do with my brother.
Hallelujah.
Everyone say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Greater work than this shall we do. Greater things. Greater. He's not going to lie. He said, greater things than you can do.
Yeah.
What do you mean? He said, you can move the mountains. You can move the mountains.
Yeah.
But the disciples said, Lord, increase our faith. What Jesus said when they said increase our faith, did he tell them that, okay, I will increase your faith? No. He said that if you have a faith like a mustard seed,
yes,
you can tell the tree to be planted by the sea and it will grow.
Yeah.
It means that you use your little faith. You use that faith, that mustard seed. You know how big is the mustard seed? It's so tiny. But if you have the faith, use it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Jesus.
But without the word of God, you cannot improve your faith.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
Faith is hearing and hearing by the word of God. Amen?
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. You need to hear the word of God and study it. Okay? Because I go to my, whatsoever ye ask in my name, that I will do, that my Father may be glorified in the Son.
Yes, hallelujah.
Anything that you ask, anything. Mm-hmm. It didn't say, if you ask money, it didn't say that. If you ask a car, it didn't say that. If you ask a house, it didn't say that. Anything that you ask in His name, He will do it, guaranteed, 100%. You know why He will do it? Because He's a man of honor. He honors His word. When He says something, He has to do it. Because He told you to. All the promises of God are yes and amen. Hallelujah. All of God's promises are yes and amen. If you shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. So what is your desire this morning? What is your desire?
Think about it.
There might be a lot of conflict going on every single day.
Mm-hmm.
You can't avoid that because the God of this world is Satan, but it's up to you to live victoriously.
Yeah.
He wants you to live victoriously because He is victorious.
Yeah.
He went to the hell. He died.
Mm-hmm.
He took our sins.
Mm-hmm.
He redeemed us.
Yeah.
It's just like you owe money, you owe somebody money, but He paid for that.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like giving a gift to you. Everyone say, I have the gift of life. Come on, I have the gift of life.
I have the gift of life.
Grace is with me every day.
Yeah.
Say it again, I have the gift of life.
I have the gift of life.
I have the gift of prosperity.
I have the gift of prosperity.
I have the gift of healing.
I have the gift of healing.
I have the gift of wisdom.
I have the gift of wisdom.
You have those gifts. Claim it. Whatever Satan stole from you, command Satan to give it back.
Amen.
Yes. Jesus.
Hundredfold. What did you lose last year? Anything? Did you lose? something, you command Satan to take it back. Return to you hundredfold.
Jesus.
The child of God, you're getting hundredfold.
Jesus.
Return it to you.
Yes.
Everybody say, Satan.
Satan.
Return.
Return.
To me.
To me.
What you stole.
What you stole.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
You have no power.
You have no power.
No authority.
No authority.
Over me.
Over me.
Return.
Return.
Those things.
Those things.
That you stole.
That you stole.
Amen.
Amen.
Because God wants you to have the fruits of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
When you have the fruits of the Holy Spirit, you are content. Mm-hmm. And wants you to rest. That's why he died at the cross of the Calvary. He wants you to rest. To have peace. Rest. Rest. You rest because you are trusting him 100% that he will do it for you.
Yes.
You're trusting him in every area of your life.
Hallelujah.
You're trusting him.
Yes.
Trust in the Lord.
Trust in the
Lord.
Trust in the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Lord. Hallelujah.
I'm going to end this.
Thank you, Jesus.
Let's go to 1 Corinthians 12, verse 7 to 11. This is my last verse. 1 Corinthians 12, verse 7 to 11. When you see it, say amen. Hallelujah. 1 Corinthians. Are you there, church? Chapter 12, verse 7 to 11. I just thought about my husband and me, Daddy and I. My husband, I'm not going to elaborate what he did, but he spent his money unwisely. So he come to me and say, forgive me, forgive me, forgive me.
Leave me alone.
Forgive me. I said, leave me alone. Please forgive me. I'm not going to do it again. Forgive me, please. And I said, I don't trust you. You see? The same thing with God. The same thing with God.
Yes.
The same thing with God.
Yes.
When you say, I don't trust you,
yes,
he's not going to bless you. But then, for a while, I was able to forgive him. The forgiving spirit of God is always there. Forgiving. No matter what you do, even though you shut a man, God is still there. Because he said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Even if you shut a man, if you did something evil, he's still there with you.
Yes.
But you have to call unto him. Once you call unto him, then he will respond. Mm-hmm. Amen?
Amen?
He will never leave you nor forsake you. Amen. Everywhere you go, he's still there.
Amen.
I'm a bad guy. I'm a bad sister. I stole things. I'm bad. He's still there. He will never leave you nor abandon you. You just have to call unto him.
Amen.
And he will be there. Amen?
Amen.
So, that can you please make 1 Corinthians 12, verse 7 to 11.
But the manifestation of the Spirit is given to every man to profit withal. For to one is given by the Spirit the word of wisdom, to another the word of knowledge by the same Spirit. To another faith by the same Spirit, to another the gifts of healing by the same Spirit. To another the working of miracles, to another prophecy, to another discerning of spirits, to another divers kinds of tongues, to another the interpretation of tongues. But all these worketh that one and the self-same Spirit, dividing to every man severally as he will.
Praise the Lord. See, the manifestation of the Spirit is given to every man.
Yes.
Every man, not only me, not only our pastor, but is given every man for the body of Christ. For the body of Christ. Some of us have a gift of healing. Some of us have a gift of understanding. Some of us have a gift of wisdom. Some of us have a gift of interpretation, gift of tongues. Some of us have a gift of what else? Tongues, miracles, anything. Those are the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Its manifestation is given to every man. Amen? Where you belong. Do you have those gifts? Do you have those gifts? Claim it today.
Yes.
Claim it today.
Yes.
Claim it today.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You want the gift of healing? You claim it. You claim that gift of healing. You can lay hands to yourself. You can lay hands to your family.
Yes.
You can lay hands to anyone that will be delivered.
Yes.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
I have the gift. Everybody say, I have the gift.
I have a gift.
Okay, let's all stand then. Let's all stand.